it's so amazing that I'm warm and my hands are like little ice blocks. Clammy ice blocks. Clammy ice blocks.
Aye, aye. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
My name is Bobby.
Hello, Bobby. Nice to meet you.
And nice to meet you. I'm based in Dallas.
Oh, wonderful.
All of the NBC stations.
Oh, okay.
And this is Tony. Have you met Tony?
Yes, we've met Tony.
Tony's my buddy.
Tony who's tired.
Tony's my buddy. Tony and I are going to run off together.
Oh, sweetie.
We're just
You're
going
to run off together?
Yeah, we haven't decided where. But we're
it's got to be an island. It's got to be an island.
We're going to.
Is this a wreck?
Nope.
Oh, thank you.
You ask him how they like the title.
Does this look big and blocky on
you? No.
Okay. I kind of would rather not.
Sorry, wearing. I was working out the kinks.
Well, you know, I was.
We've got the same thing. Yeah, exactly.
It's
right.
It does what it does, doesn't it?
Yeah, turtlenecks have a mind of their own.
Thanks.
Very good.
I know, don't worry. You saw me looking before I went in.
Do me a favor, reach under and just pull your shirt down just a little bit.
We got it? Okay. So now, what do you do? Do you go from everyone set up in a different room,
mm-hmm.
and you just go from
room to room?
Oh, yes.
Okay, Bobby, you have speed.
And are you doing the Foxy Brown thing too?
No.
Okay,
because
I know that's happening on one of the other.
Well, doing Jackie Brown.
Jackie Brown. That's Brown. I'm sorry, Foxy Brown is 60s. Coffee Brown.
Tomorrow, it's good to see you.
Nice to see you.
And congratulations to you on your film debut.
Thank you.
Yes, in Senseless. Of course, you're not new to acting because you've been doing some TV work for quite a while. What are you currently doing in television?
Actually, in television, currently nothing.
So that's in the past.
I wouldn't say that it's a closed door entirely, but it's just right now, you know, we just finished the film. There are a couple of other projects sort of lined up, but it's not TV, so.
So how did the film come about then?
Well, I got the script. It was just a very, very, how shall we say, it was a very, very normal setup. I got the script, read the script, loved it, and then went to the audition, met Marlon, met Penelope, and the rest is history.
But you didn't know Marlon or any of those people ahead of time?
I actually knew Marlon, personally, like through friends, but had never worked with him before, so.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, it's really a very nice role for a film debut role, don't you think?
I think so.
Yes. In this movie, Senseless, Marlon does all these various jobs, and they're pretty outrageous. That's where the comedy comes from.
Exactly.
Have you ever had to do any outrageous jobs?
Oh. Actually, you know, I don't think, not quite as outrageous as the stuff Marlon had to do. They actually asked me to do a few sort of out things for me in this film. And I don't know, you recall a couple of the weird scenes where I had to have strange reaction. Those were big for me. I'm used to making acting a really sort of organic, small experience. So to do this was a real joy.
When you were starting as an actress, did you have any sidebar jobs that you had to do?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
like what?
I did just about everything. We did telemarketing for a while. I worked at, several different restaurants, catering, anything you could name I was doing.
And this was to pay for acting lessons or what?
Yeah. I was going to say, in Toronto, I did most of the odd jobs. Once I got out here, I sort of fell right into the acting.
What was it that brought you from Toronto to California?
Actually, my best friend brought me out here. I was sort of inspired because we're both from Toronto, Canada, and she moved out here. And I'd come to visit her. Like once a year, I'd come and hang out for a month, and she ended up doing a TV show. And I'd sort of hang around the set and see what they were doing, and I thought, okay. I like this because they were all tremendously talented on this show. So I thought, well, this is sort of accessible. Maybe I could do this too. And that's what brought me out here.
But But you were not an actress in Toronto?
No, I had wanted to. I think acting was something that I always wanted to do, but I was painfully shy and thought, you know, this isn't within my grasp. I think that maybe I should stick to something more simple, you know, something a little more introverted, but here I am.
What did you think you might do?
I wasn't quite sure. I figured if I wasn't an actor, I'd be an archaeologist. I you know, something like that, certainly not in the entertainment industry, so.
I'm sure that you're going to have many film offers from this film. Is there anything definite, or what are you looking at?
Nothing definite. I never like to speak about things until they happen, but nothing definite as of yet.
If you could use someone as a role model for how you would like your career to develop, who would it be?
Oh, boy. Probably Audrey Hepburn. She's
Bless
my
you.
favorite.
Bless you. That's interesting because you're of a different generation.
Yeah.
How do you happen to be so fond of Audrey Hepburn's work?
I don't know. I can't even remember who it was that that sort of hipped me to her. It certainly wasn't my mom. I think maybe one day I was at an audition and I was wearing a polka dot dress, I remember, and this casting lady said, "Wow, doesn't she kind of remind you?" And I think it was the whole, it was, I definitely looked like something out of another era. And she said, "Doesn't she sort of remind you of Audrey Hepburn?" And up until then, I hadn't even heard of the name. So of course, when I heard the name, I thought, well, if this is someone that I reminded her of, I should know her work. I should know who she is. And of course, fell in love with her as soon as I saw her movies. So.
What was the first Audrey Hepburn movie you saw?
Sabrina.
Ah, okay. Okay, well, that was a good one.
That was a good one.
Try Roman Holiday.
Oh, loved Roman Holiday, and that was her first one.
We could sit here and talk all day about Audrey Hepburn.
Man.
Tamara, congratulations to you, and
Thank you.
Wish you all the best. And I'm sure that come a year or two, we'll be sitting here talking again, and we'll pick up right where we left off.
Love it.
Thank you. That was lovely. Thank you.
Thank you.
See, I'm a big Audrey Hepburn.
Yeah, it's so amazing that I'm warm, and my hands are like little ice blocks. Clammy ice blocks. Clammy ice blocks.
Aye, aye. Good morning.
Good morning. How
My
are you?
My name is Bobby.
Hello, Bobby. Nice to meet you.
And nice to meet you. I'm based in Dallas.
Oh, wonderful.
All of the NBC stations.
Oh, okay.
And this is Tony. Have you met Tony?
Yes, we've met Tony.
Tony's my buddy.
Tony who's tired.
Tony's my buddy. Tony and I are going to run off together.
Oh, sweetie.
We're just
You're going
to
run off together?
Yeah, we haven't decided where. But
it's got to be an island. It's got to be an island.
We're going to.
Yeah. Is this a wreck?
Nope.
Oh, thank you.
You ask him how they like the title.
Does this look big and blocky on?
No.
I kind of would rather not.
Sorry, wearing. I was working out the kinks.
Well, you know, I was.
We've got the
testing.
Same thing. Yeah, exactly. It's
really. It kind of does what it does, doesn't it?
Yeah, turtlenecks have a mind of their
Thanks.
Own.
Thanks.
Very good.
I know, don't worry. You saw me looking before I went in.
Do me a favor, reach under and just pull your shirt down just a little bit.
We got it? Okay. So now, what do you go from everyone set up in a different room,
mm-hmm.
and you just go from room to room?
Oh. Yes.
Okay, Bobby, you have speed.
And are you doing the Foxy Brown thing too?
No.
Okay, because I know that's happening on one of the other.
Well, doing Jackie Brown.
Jackie Brown. That's. I'm sorry, Foxy Brown is 60s. Coffee Brown.
Tomorrow, it's good to see you.
Nice to see you.
And congratulations to you on your film debut.
Thank you.
Yes, in Senseless. Of course, you're not new to acting because you've been doing some TV work for quite a while. What are you currently doing in television?
Actually, in television, currently nothing. Nothing.
So that's in the past.
I wouldn't say that it's a closed door entirely, but it's just right now, you know, we just finished the film. There are a couple of other projects sort of lined up, but it's not TV, so.
So how did the film come about then?
Well, I got the script. It was just a very, very how shall we say, it was a very, very normal setup. I got the script, read the script, loved it, and then went to the audition, met Marlon, met Penelope, and the rest is history.
But you didn't know Marlon or any of those people ahead of time?
I actually knew Marlon personally, like through friends, but had never worked with him before, so.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, it's really a very nice role for a film debut role, don't you think?
I think so.
Yes. In this movie, Senseless, Marlon does all these various jobs. And they're pretty outrageous. That's where the comedy comes from.
Exactly.
Have you ever had to do any outrageous jobs?
Oh. Actually, you know, I don't think, not quite as outrageous as the stuff Marlon had to do. They actually asked me to do a few sort of out things for me in this film. And I don't know, you recall a couple of the weird scenes where I had to have strange reactions. Those were big for me. I'm used to making acting a really sort of organic, small experience. So to do this was a real joy.
When you were starting as an actress, did you have any sidebar jobs that you had to do?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
like what?
I did just about everything. We did telemarketing for a while. I worked at, several different restaurants, catering, anything you could name I was doing.
And this was to pay for acting lessons or what?
Yeah. I was going to say, in Toronto, I did most of the odd jobs. Once I got out here, I sort of fell right into the acting.
What was it that brought you from Toronto to California?
Actually, my best friend brought me out here. I was sort of inspired because we're both from Toronto, Canada, and she moved out here. And I'd come to visit her. Like once a year, I'd come and hang out for a month, and she ended up doing a TV show. And I'd sort of hang around the set and see what they were doing, and I thought, okay, I like this, because they were all tremendously talented on this show. So I thought, well, this is sort of accessible. Maybe I could do this too, and that's what brought me out here.
But you were not an actress in Toronto?
No, I had wanted to. I think acting was something that I always wanted to do, but I was painfully shy and thought, you know, this isn't within my grasp. I think that maybe I should stick to something more simple, you know, something a little more introverted, but here I am.
What did you think you might do?
I wasn't quite sure. I figured if I wasn't an actor, I'd be an archaeologist. I you know, something like that. Certainly not in the entertainment industry, so.
I'm sure that you're going to have many film offers from this film. Is there anything definite, or what are you looking at?
Nothing definite. I never like to speak about things until they happen, but nothing definite as of yet.
If you could use someone as a role model for how you would like your career to develop, who would it be?
Oh, boy. Probably Audrey Hepburn. She's
Bless
my
you.
favorite.
Yeah. Bless you. That's interesting because you're of a different generation.
Yeah.
How do you happen to be so fond of Audrey Hepburn's work?
I don't know. I can't even remember who it was that sort of hit me to her. It certainly wasn't my mom. I think maybe one day I was at an audition and I was wearing a polka dot dress, I remember, and this casting lady said, "Wow, doesn't she kind of remind you?" And I think it was the whole, it was, I definitely looked like something out of another era, and she said, "Doesn't she sort of remind you of Audrey Hepburn?" And up until then, I hadn't even heard of the name. So, of course, when I heard the name, I thought, well, if this is someone that I reminded her of, I should know her work. I should know who she is. And, of course, fell in love with her as soon as I saw her movies. So.
What was the first Audrey Hepburn movie you saw?
Sabrina.
Ah, okay. Well, that was a good one.
That was a good one.
Try Roman Holiday.
Oh, loved Roman Holiday. And that was her first one.
We could sit here and talk all day about Audrey Hepburn.
Man.
Tamara, congratulations to you, and
Thank you.
Wish you all the best. And I'm sure that come a year or two, we'll be sitting here talking again, and we'll pick up right where we left off.
Love it.
Thank you.
You.
That was lovely. Thank you.
Thank you.
See, I'm a big Audrey.